I am Dr. Atul Limaye. I am a senior interventional cardiologist at Fortis Hospital in Mulund, Mumbai. There has been a rapid advancement in medical technology over the past several years, particularly in the area of treatment of heart valve diseases. Aortic stenosis is a particular problem for which now there is a novel non-surgical way to treat it. This procedure is called transcatheter aortic valve implantation. Aortic stenosis essentially is narrowing of the aortic valve. This valve is one of the important valves in our heart, which controls the flow of blood from the heart to the entire rest of the body. In some people, particularly with aging, or if they have a deformed heart valve at birth, or if they have rheumatic heart disease, this aortic valve becomes calcified, stiff, and stenotic, that is, it becomes narrowed. Blood has difficulty getting through the aortic valve and going to the rest of the body. Typically, patients will complain of chest discomfort on exertion, or shortness of breath, or they may have unexplained episodes of passing out or blacking out. The diagnosis is fairly straightforward. The doctor essentially can pick up the harsh murmur of aortic stenosis when he auscultates the patient. An echocardiogram confirms the diagnosis of severe aortic stenosis. Over the last several decades, open heart surgery with surgical valve replacement was the only way to treat aortic stenosis. Over the last several years, and in India for the last 5 years or so, there is now a novel non-surgical way to treat aortic valve diseases. This method is called transcatheter aortic valve implantation, also known as TAVI. This procedure essentially is like doing an angiogram, but obviously much more complicated. It requires a dedicated professional training to be able to do TAVI. It requires a multidisciplinary team. It ideally should be done in a tertiary care hospital with adequate surgical backup. The valve is essentially threaded through a large artery in the groin, taken to its position on fluoroscopy in the catheterization lab, and implanted in its right position across the old aortic valve. This requires no surgery whatsoever. The entire procedure takes about an hour to perform. Patients typically stay in the hospital for 2 to 3 days and are discharged on the third or the fourth day. When we started doing this procedure, we used to do it under general anesthesia. But recently, with more experience, we are now able to do it in local anesthesia with conscious sedation. Patient recovery is dramatically quick, and as I said before, patients can be discharged home in 3 to 4 days. The biggest advantage is in patients who are either frail or elderly, or patients who have already have had 1 or 2 open heart surgeries in the past. They are reluctant to undergo another extensive open heart procedure because their body may not allow it, or because they may be at very high risk for complications from open heart surgery. Such patients are really ideal for a minimally invasive transcatheter valve implantation procedure.